And new developments tonight in the death of a toddler in Greeley. She was left alone Saturday night, and her family's mobile home caught fire. Well, the Call 7 investigators obtaining court records that show two very different versions of what happened. Call 7 investigator John Ferrugia joins us live from the newsroom with more on this. John?
Well, Ann, those two different stories are from Lily Kellenair's mother and her mother's boyfriend. Both now are charged with child abuse, resulting in Lily's death.
The fire was just ablaze, and I just kept on hearing the mom say, "My daughter's in there, my daughter's in there."
Court records show that Lily Ann Kellenair's had burns over 60% of her body. She died a little more than an hour after the home caught fire.
When I seen her, she was breathing, but I turned, not even 5 minutes later, I turned and she was, that's it.
Her mother, 27-year-old Kristen Bragg, told police she was gone from the trailer only 5 minutes to take trash to a dumpster. And then she stopped at a neighbor's to ask her boyfriend to come home. But the boyfriend, 34-year-old Dustin Blanchard, told police something much different. He says he and Bragg were outside smoking marijuana and drinking alcohol for about 15 minutes while Lily slept inside. He says he then went to a neighbor's trailer. Those neighbors say both Bragg and Blanchard visited for another 15 minutes before the fire.
Honestly, it gets me mad. I mean, because that little girl didn't deserve to go like that. She didn't deserve to be left alone.
Also conflicting, Bragg and Blanchard's guesses as to how that fire started. He told police it could have been a bandana placed over a light. Bragg says two candles were left burning in the home where Lily was left alone. Now, according to the affidavit, officers heard shots when they first arrived at the home on Saturday night. Blanchard told them he kept three loaded guns in the home. He and Bragg are now out on bond tonight. They're expected back in court next month. In the newsroom, I'm Call 7 investigator John Ferrugia.